this turnaround service will answer for you. God is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think. Hear me? Whatever has resisted you till today, we bow. If you are saying amen, say better amen. This service will focus on turnaround in decisions, enchantments, spells, and embargoes. Hear me and hear me well. I don't know who your strong man is, but I have one bullet for them today. They will go down by the power of the word. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Lift up your voice and say, Lord, you are a specialist in turning things around. Turn things around in my favor. Turn things around in my destiny. Turn things around for my family. Turn things around concerning my marriage. Turn things around concerning my job. Wipe away my tears. Turn things around. Story changer. Only you can do what no man can do. No, what no man can change, only you can change it. The story changer, show yourself for me in this service. Nabo shikeho sataladesh. Ensizu epre ikata. Story changer, only you can do what no man can do. Do what makes you awesome. Do what makes you El Shaddai. Do what makes you Jehovah Rapha. Do what makes you Jehovah Nisi. Labo Shihe Tenedi Ezozelikata. Thank you for your unfailing word. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus mighty name we have prayed. If you are saying amen, say it better amen. The turnaround God will locate you this morning. Make that amen louder. Put those hands together for Jesus. And please be seated. God bless you. This service is turning to be a 24-hour miracle service. I'm beginning the message with a testimony. We had a sister in my former station. Thank God she works in the hospital. He told her she had a lump in her breast. And that they will need to do surgery to cut the breast. I asked her, cut which breast? She said, her breast. I said, which one will your baby suck? She showed me the x-ray. I said, thank God for the x-ray. But, relax. The sojourn of heaven will take the lump away. After a word-loaded service, she went again to do another x-ray. What do they call it? Is it mammogram or something like that? Yeah. They couldn't find it. So the dean in charge of that radiography had to come down to come and check. After checking, he asked her, what did you take? I said, nothing. No, he wanted to hear something. That my pastor only prayed for me. He said, which church? He said, Living Faith Church, Rayfield. He said, I've been hearing of that church. He said, which means you don't need any surgery again. Go. God is going to change your own story. There's another one. Although she did house in fear, they told her she had cancer of the cervix. Women, they know what I'm talking about. And the thing has affected the womb, that she will need to cut off the womb. That's it. I said, I'm not too comfortable with that arrangement. Even though you are past the age of giving birth, what's the, you know, the husband was a surgeon before he passed on. They've told her already that they've already seen cancer. I say, cancer has ear, and he must obey me. She has already gone to remove it. But after a month passed, they went and checked. No more cancer. So even the surgeon is an old man. The man was confused. He said, What really happened? He said, me too, I can't explain. He said, did you drink anything or did you take any something? He said, it's just that my pastor only prayed. He said, which pastor? I know you as an Anglican. He said, I'm now worshiping Rayfield. He said, that's your pastor. It's like he's using something. He's not using anything. He's only using God. And that was how she was now saying, if I had listened to you. You know, I'm your pastor, but you still have your choice to believe me or to doubt me. She started rolling on the altar and said, Lord, forgive me for going to remove it. The thing has already gone. Now, there's another one which someone needs to hear. How many of us have heard the word kidney stone? I won't call his name. Somebody here may know him. He's a known medical doctor in Plateau State. Not that he was our member. The wife only comes for a Monday, Friday prayer until she finally became a member. The man had this thing that has been troubling him, and hear me, people that are suffering from that kidney stone, going to urinate is a problem. It will look as if they are trying to like use syringe to draw blood from their body. He was not in the service. I only prayed and I said, go, just anoint him. And as she went, God healed this man of kidney stone. He's not the one telling the wife, it's time for church. Be going. Hear me and hear me well. The story changer is in church. And whatever has resisted you till today, it will bow. If you are saying amen, say better amen. God's word is God's power. God has no power outside of his word. God can do nothing outside of his word. God's word cannot be broken. What God says is already done. God's word can undo. God's word can reshape. God's word can alter. It can change. It can reverse. It can cancel. And that is why I want your expectation to be up this morning. Because when God says a thing, scripture says he watcheth over his word to perform it. He says, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish and prosper in the thing wheresoever I send it. And scripture told me we are heirs of God and joint heir with Christ. So if I say it, he will confirm it. The centurion said unto Jesus, I'm a man under authority. I said to one, go, and they go. And to another, come, and they come. I want to say to someone this morning, whatever decision that was passed over you by wickedness, I stand this morning on the platform as a son of the prophets. That wicked decision is altered. That satanic embargo is altered. In case you forget any aspect of the message, don't forget this. If a native doctor smelling is sure that his enchantment will produce, don't expect my own word to deliver less. I didn't come to Lafia because I want to be in Lafia. I am sent. And if I am sent, I am backed up. And if I am backed up, my word is not supposed to fall to the ground. Hear me and hear me well. The enemy will give up on you today. There is no devil, no witch, no vow of any wicked man that can subject you to what God did not pre-plan for you. That's why I pity any man or any woman on assignment to monitor your bad situation. They will be wasted like chicken. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Scripture said the Lord of hosts has proposed, and who shall disannul? His hand is stretched out. Hear me? God's stretching hand is a function of his sent word. Wherever God's word goes and somebody believes, his hand is stretched. I was reading the testimony of Pioneer Kadegboye. He went to minister in Port Harcourt and some years back, and one man happened to be his privileged driver. So he carried him all around from the hotel to the place of the meeting, to and fro, came back, finished. So as they finished, he took him back to the airport. So he now gave him some money and said, give this to your children. The man was just shouting, amen, 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 amen. The man didn't tell him, I'm expecting a child. So he now asked the pastor, why is this man saying amen, amen, amen? He said, they are expecting their children. He said, ah, God has answered the prayer. A year later, he came back. He brought a gift to Pioneer Kadegbe. This is gift from my children. Only you can do what no man can do. Hear me and hear me well. I came to disgrace your enemies. Hear it again. I came to disgrace your enemies. Who knew what has kept him under bound? But when the word went forth, give this gift to your children. There must be physical presence to receive the gifts. And the spiritual controls the physical. Whatever needs a turnaround in your life that has been manipulated by wickedness, I reverse it today. Amen. I reverse it today. Amen. I reverse it today. Amen. I reverse it today. Beginning from creation, we see God demonstrating his power by his word. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12, the word of the Lord is quick and powerful. Sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of the souls and of the spirit and of the joints and marrow. And it's a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Is quick and powerful. The awesomeness of God is in his word. The blessings of God is in his word. So nothing happens until God says it will happen. When he said, let there be light, light had no option than to appear. Scripture says, and darkness was hovering over the surface of the deep. And God said, let there be light. So let there be must be a continuous declaration. That's why you must be conscious of what comes out of your mouth. Your turnaround is in your mouth. Yes, your turnaround is in your mouth. I give you a mouth and a wisdom which your adversary shall not be able to resist nor gainsay. I give you a mouth and a wisdom. As soon as they hear of me, they shall submit themselves unto me, and the stranger shall fade away. Even if they have overpowered you, thank God you are in church, everyone under the sound of my voice. Whatever has overpowered you against your will, I command them to give up on you today. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. I just heard God say just now, a witch will die because of you today. Amen. I cannot be poor. You have said it. Must work for me the way I desire it. God will confirm it. He said, we do the very thing that I hear you say. For a sister, I can't lack husband. My husband must come. He must come home. Because whatever you say, that's what determines what you will see. Shall I say this? Your mouth is not borrowed. Did you borrow your mouth? I give you a mouth and a wisdom. We are are in a warfare of words. Warfare. So you must keep saying what you want to see. Even though there are enemies that are angry, they will die for nothing. So you need to keep declaring what you want to see God do. So stop describing your situation. Start declaring your expectation. The area you want to see turn around, begin to enforce the word in that direction. Keep shooting the word. Keep sending the word. Keep shooting the word. Do you know why the word is cast in your mouth? You are not sure whether it's working. But if you believe the word, you will know that any time you release it, you are not just talking. You are committing the Spirit of God. Jesus said, these words that I speak, they are spirits. And they are what? Life. In case there are informants here, hear it well. Dear me and dear my family, I will invoke all the prophetic grace upon my life against you. You will be roasted. I don't need to know your name. I'll be shooting the arrow. It must catch you. It will catch you. Catch the person that sent you. If you live the way your enemy wants, it is your choice. It's your choice. Everything we need for our turnaround has already been delivered. Everything we need for our turnaround has already been delivered. Scripture says he has given to us everything that pertains to life and what? Godliness. So you are not permitted to be subjected to pity. You are not permitted to be subjected to weeping. What you just need to do, believe your God. Believe his word. Believe your prophet. You may be in church and I'm not your prophet. It's possible. Because any pastor you don't believe, don't say amen to his prayer. You will just die for nothing. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? Any pastor you don't believe and you have been speaking again, don't say amen to his prayer. Run away. Because your dryness is getting more confirmed. You know, some people can just foolishly come and sit down. What is he saying, self? You are dying. Run for your life. Locate another place where you can go and take cover. Because a pastor is sent only to a specific people whom God has ordained that through him they will move forward. They will make progress. Experience breakthrough. But you go and stay. Nonsense. Yeah, yeah. That's how a woman came for a meeting that Papa was preaching. She did like this. And God gave her stone in her womb. 1996. So I can be preaching now and be praying for people to be blessed. Someone say, I don't know whether now block God will drop for you. It's true now. So she has been doing all manner of things. She now went to a particular church and God now had mercy through that prophet. There is a man of God you insulted. If he does not pray for you, nobody can bail you out. She was now wondering, which man of God? He said, I don't know. Go and think. Allow the Spirit to reveal it to you. So she now went back, started doing emergency fasting, emergency prayer. Holy Ghost, show me the man of God. So in a trance, the Holy Ghost reminded her when she is. She now quickly knew the person. She now ran to go and meet Papa. Then church was now in Rajioba. You know, then protocol don't change level. She made sure she entered to see Papa. Finally, please pray for me. I've sinned against you. How? Papa said, no, you didn't sin against me. He said, I was in a meeting in Jos when you were praying for people and I hissed. And since then, a stone was planted in my womb. And the man of God said, if you don't pray for me, that the story will not change. He said, that's why I'm here. She knelt down. Papa said, you are forgiven. You didn't sin against me. I'm not the one that gave you stone. It's God that gave you stone. Go. You are delivered. 1 year later, she became pregnant. Let me say this. Any oil you mock kills you. Any oil you mock finishes you. I want us to come to a point where we will believe God and believe his word, and we will be seeing our change take place face by face. Increase for increase. Progress for progress. The word of the Lord is quick and is powerful. Hear me? God's word operates like a projectile. Let me explain for you. You may not know what a projectile is. A projectile is programmed on an assignment to a specific location, to a specific target. Until it locates its target, it cannot explode. The moment it locates its target, bah, mission accomplished. Day to day will get signal, this thing has accomplished. That's how God's word operates. Every time his word is sent, it must. That's why I say, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish. But you know what? Many people believe God's word in their head, not in their hearts. Scripture says, with their heart, man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. So anything can be turned around in your life. Your marital situation can be turned around. Your business can be turned around. Your family situation can be turned around. Your finances can be turned around. I remember a young man that came recently, I think this year. He said, somebody removed something from his hand in the dream. And since that time, things are not working again. I said, they removed something. I said, I'm going to put something now. So, I rubbed oil in my palm. I said, open your hand. I placed my two hands. I spoke in tongues. I said, from today, this hand, carry blessing. Carry favor. Watch out. Before you know what's happening, what he has never handled before, he started handling it. Hear me, hear me well. I don't know what they collected from your hand. I speak with authority. Lift up those hands. I speak with prophetic authority. Your hand will encounter favor. Your hand will handle fortune. The evil rope tying that hand, I command it cut off in the name of Jesus. Words carry power. The word of God carries the authority of God. No wonder scripture say, I have exalted my word above my name. So anything your life require, your family require, your business require, the word. Oh, I just remembered a testimony now. My friend, we are classmates in university. The mother was working in the Ministry of External Affairs. She was due for promotion. But one man vowed that the promotion will not take place. So he now met me one day. He said, we need to pray. If this promotion takes place, the implication is that my mother will be promoted and she will be transferred either as an ambassador or the head of an embassy following an ambassador. I said, why not? That's a good prayer. We head hands together and pray. He said, Lord, whoever is sitting on that promotion, uproots the person in less than 1 month. Redeploy to another place. And funny enough, an Alahaji came to the office. The man didn't even waste time. Just approved the thing quick. The first posting, Syria alone. Now the woman is just moving from one country to another. Whoever is sitting on your promotion, whoever is sitting on your change of level, and has vowed that your story will not change, I command them uprooted! In the name of Jesus! I remember another testimony just now. A brother working in an oil company. The white man is a German in Port Harcourt. He told him that before I am back, you are sacked. Before I am back, you are sacked. So this brother went and reported to Archbishop Samamanga that before, he said, before he is back, I am sacked. So Archbishop Amanga just held his hand and prayed for him in tongues. Go back to his office. Don't touch the door. You will not come back. Guess what happened? Malaria killed him in Germany. Is there malaria in Germany? Whoever has vowed a vow for you, they will never live to see your testimony. We never live to see your testimony. The evil plan they have cooked for you. Oh, this is a dangerous one. It will backfire against them in the name of Jesus. If you are saying amen, say better amen. If you are not saying amen, you are a winch. Knew. I'm sure that brother must have been a committed server. Do you agree with me? Since thou art precious in my sight and I have loved thee, I will give the life of men as a ransom for thee and people for thy life. Before I'm backed, you are sacked. So the man say, sack? Sack? He sacked him in the realm of the spirit. Mosquito that beat him here in Nigeria went and killed him there in Germany. You can't stop the world from turning things. He said, I will overturn and overturn and overturn until whose turn it is. It is your turn today. I say it again, it is your turn today. And God is turning it in your favor. If you must experience a turnaround, you must take command by the word. Because everything on earth hears the word. Everything in the spirit hears the word. So by the word, you can speak to any part of your life. Can speak to any part of your life. You can speak to any contrary situation. You can alter any evil counsel. You can even place judgment on people fighting your blessing. You can place judgment on them. Isaiah 54 and verse 17. Let's read that scripture now. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper. And every tongue. How many? That shall rise against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. Do you know what it means to condemn? Write off. Please put the scripture back. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. Are you serving God? And their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. No weapon. So every weapon of failure formed against you, it shall not prosper. Whoever fired the arrow of failure, I command the arrow to go back upon them. In the name of Jesus Christ, no weapon. He said, there is no enchantment against Judah. My dear, is there any divination against Israel? So every time we speak the word, we commit God. You can't commit God to your turnaround until you speak the word of God. To get God committed for things to turn around for you, delay marriage, speak the word. Seek ye out of the book of the law and read. None of these shall fail, neither shall any want admit. Lord, whatever is delaying my marital destiny, in the name of Jesus, let the spell break. Let the power of manipulation break. You are speaking the word. Isaiah 34 verse 16. Seek ye out of the book of the law and read, and no one of these shall fail. None shall want a mate, for my mouth it hath commanded. So your mouth put you in command. And his spirit, it hath gathered them. If your mouth does not say it, the spirit will not go to bring it. It's only what you say that the Spirit goes to bring. And God said, let there be light. And there was light. Why was there light? And the Spirit of the Lord was hovering over the surface of the deep, waiting to establish what God has said. So every time you declare, God confirms. So if you don't declare, you will not clear. What you declare will determine what God will clear. What you declare determine what God will clear. Jesus said unto Peter, cast thy nets for a catch. Master, we have toiled all night and day, but we have caught nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word. Shall I tell you? The omniscience does not depend on science. Science came from him. For by him all things were made, visible and invisible. By my privileged understanding of hydrologic cycle, fishes don't come to the surface because the water temperature is minus 4 degrees. They go under, which is zero. Under the water is warm than the surface. The surface is chilly, so they go under. But because Jesus said, let down your nets for a catch, the fishes they heard, then they call us. Then they call us. Then they call us. Oh yeah, make we go. Then they call us. And all of them began. They came with speed. Now, how do I know that they came with speed? After he threw the net, they entered with speed to the point that scripture say his nets began to do what? Now wait, they tear nets. The weight of the fishes were so massive. I want to let you know, fishing nets is elastic. Do you agree with me? It's elastic. It's not cutting wool. And you know, the way the net is tied is so cohesive to the point that you cannot just easily break it except the whole knife. But the weight of the fishes break. Did Jesus call fish? Let down your nets for a catch. The word that is coming now will catch something. Amen. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. Whatever you have been pursuing, this week you will catch it. Amen. That favor you have been pursuing, this week you will catch it. Open door you have been pursuing, this week you will catch it. Somebody's not saying amen. You have been running after somebody for a favor. I say between now and Wednesday, the person will not rest until he locates you. The person will not rest until he locates you. Person will not rest until he locates you. The person will not sleep well until you are settled. Let down your nets for a catch. Funny enough, Jesus didn't need to know whether the fishes are coming. Let me give us another clear scenario. Peter, go to the stream now. You will catch a fish. Inside his mouth is a coin. Bitcoin. Hallelujah. Is it today that coin started? Jesus was the one that first talked about coin. You will catch a fish. In his mouth is what? A coin. Bitcoin. For the coin to be able to pay the debt, man, it must have been Bitcoin kind. Do you agree with me? And thank you. He didn't go there to do random sampling. Am I correct? Yes, he didn't go to do random sampling. As he got there, he caught the fish with the golden coin. Not Kajiswa, Mark, I hope you check your mouth. Maybe you. Maybe you. He caught the specific fish. The specific fish knew that it was the one that the master needs. Whoever is carrying what you are looking for, this week they will not get you. This week they will not get you. Every barrier to that expected blessing, I command them crushed in the name of Jesus. It is settled for someone. I say it is settled for someone. God's word carry God's power. Let me say this as I summarize. Every turn around requires a force. A breaking force. A crushing force. And I know that devil by nature, they are stubborn. Witches, they are stubborn. Evil men and evil women, they are stubborn. But I like their stubbornness. Do you know why? He that is often reproved and hardeneth his neck, he says, he shall suddenly be destroyed and without what? Remedy. Hear the word now. Whoever has resisted your turnaround, today I pronounce 24-hour vengeance. Today I declare 24-hour vengeance. Anyone under the sound of my voice, whatever the devil has been using against you, I invoke the vengeance of God against them. For a turnaround to take place, a force must be exerted. Since the day of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of God suffered violence. And the violent take it by force. Your life will remain the same way it is without power. The power of the word. The Holy Ghost flows in the direction of the word. Your frustration will continue. Your stagnation will grow thicker. Your disappointment will keep increasing without the power of the word. So it takes power to force the enemy to submit. Oh, I hear this word right now. Anyone coming to LFC Lafia as an agent of Satan, as a monitoring spirit, I prophesy on this altar, your calamity starts today. Your disaster starts today. In the name of Jesus. That which you are on assignment for, let it start with you and your family. That word has caught somebody. I say it has caught somebody. I say that word has caught somebody. Their shame will start from now. The word requires power. And hear me, power is your inheritance in Christ. What is the lamb that was slain to receive power? Jesus did not receive power for himself. You received it on your behalf, on my behalf. He a tarry in Jerusalem until you receive the gift of my Father. So when power comes, things must turn. He said, you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. That power is what we call divine enablement. So it is impossible for things to turn around without the power of the Holy Ghost. Hear me, and hear me well. Things can turn. Things can turn. Things can turn. Things can turn. Things will turn for you. Oh, I just remembered one medical doctor. She's a medical doctor. The husband, medical doctor. They were about going for IVF after 8 years of trial. After a season word like this, they just made up their mind that the money that they were going to use for the IVF, $750,000, they just sold it to God. That month, she became pregnant. As the pregnancy began to grow, her fellow doctors began to suspect tumor. So she kept quiet and was just thanking God. The pregnancy was growing and growing and growing and growing. So even the husband himself, may what you know not confuse you. Amen. Some people now over sabi they do that. Sabi, sabi. God has done it, all, but the husband was still saying, can this be real? Because he knows medicine, MBBS, MTN, MHQ. Are you hearing me now? He couldn't believe it. So on the day of the delivery, started shedding tears. God is real. God is real. God will make himself real in your life. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. So on the day of her testimony, she said, I never knew it was going to be this cheap. Hear me and hear me well. Not by power, not by might, but by my spirit. Rise up to your feet. By my spirit. We're going to sing this song before I pray for you. Before you pray, and I'll pray for you. Everything is turning around for my. You sabi that song? Ellie. You sabi this song? Oh yeah, come, come, come. Everything is turning around for my good. Everything is turning around for my good. Everything is turning around for my good. Everything is turning around for my good.
Oh, I can see everything
turning around.
As you are dancing, things are turning
around.
I can see everything
turning around. Turning around. Turning around. Turning around.
Oh, I can see
turning around. Turning around. Turning around.
Oh, I can see you.
Turning around. Turning around. Turning around. Oh, my God.
you have even seen it in the dream. I speak with prophetic authority. That evil Lord, go back to the sender. That evil Lord, go back to the sender. You are going to pray now. Father, Jabez prayed, oh, that thy hand will be upon me, and that evil will not grieve me. What Jabez was doing was pray for turnaround. Father, I place a demand on your hand. Overturn every evil. Overturn every plan of wickedness. Overturn every evil cancer. I place a demand on your hand. I place a demand on your hand. Clear every barrier. In this banquet turnaround service, I place a demand on your hand. Overturn. You said you will overturn and overturn and overturn until whose turn it is. Lord, it is my turn today. Overturn every works of the wicked. Overturn every satanic cancer. Overturn every satanic manipulation. I demand my turnaround by the power that is in the name of Jesus. I demand a turnaround. I demand a turnaround in my life, in my assignment, in my life, in my family, in my wife, in my children, in our finance, in our business. I demand a turnaround for my family. I demand a turnaround for Living Faith Church Lafia. I demand a turnaround. Lerian de Kiketu Sesone Reshata Ekoto Esuse Eklekete Shetu Esata Impatete Dusa Shekuteto Likatare Shite Embrutana Edalata Sheklopebre Etesosa In Sutu Esata Ekateto Shetulia Ekaletata. I demand a turnaround. I demand a turnaround. Father, overturn. I place a demand on your hand. Overturn. Overturn. By the power of your spirit. Overturn. I demand a turnaround. By the power of your spirit. Overturn. I demand a turnaround. I place a demand on your hand. Lerindo. Jesus Ekiketolia in Prate Lijoteros Lekuta Palish Zenerio Chakala Bretete Likuteros Zanate Tule Rushata Ipratolia Sheklopebre Zunene Rekotutu Lavashada. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Somebody's turnaround here begins by accepting Jesus. You can be in church and not be in Christ. That does not guarantee you a turnaround. You want to make it right with Jesus wherever you are. Put your right hand on your chest and say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I come unto you today. I know that I'm a sinner. Forgive me. Wash me with your precious blood. I reject sin. I reject Satan. Come into my life. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. If you pray that prayer with me, come forward right now. I want to pray with you. Wherever you are, inside Jesus, and outside, take your bag and your Bible and come. God bless you. Just come quickly. Make it quick now. Put your hands together for Jesus. If you're coming, come quickly. God bless you. Come, come, come. Come. You don't need to be ashamed. Come. Come, come, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. If you're coming, come quickly.
You've taken me from the miry place. Set my feet upon the rock, and now I know.
Something now. There is someone that witches are programmed to kill. He wants to go to the village this week. I'm not saying everybody is going to village which want to kill you. But there's a particular person. Everybody, place your right hand on your head. Any power on assignment to waste you, let the programmer be wasted. In the name of the God of Oyedepo, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, any witchcraft altar hired to kill you, let the person making the enchantment die for your sake. So shall it be. In Jesus' name we pray. As this oil come upon you, your story has changed. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Your story have changed. I say your story have changed. I say your story have changed. I say your story have changed. So shall it be. Put your hands together for Jesus, for
them. I love you. I need you. You're my only goal.
By a prophet, God brought Israel out of Egypt. My first month in Refid. Not that the person have come to visit me. Not that we knew before. God appeared to her in a dream using my face. He said, stop crying, stop crying, stop crying. That testimony, you are getting it this month. Guess what? You know, fibroid is in levels. Are you getting what I'm saying now? There are massive fibroids that can make pregnancy impossible. But guess what? She became pregnant. It was the day of the dedication that I knew. Now, another one had a testimony and told the daughter in Abuja, see, oh, this person don't bump kiddo, so you must bump. So that fibroid is not a problem. Guess what? She took it. Baby was growing. Fibroid was growing. She called me that the doctor said they should terminate the pregnancy. What no man can start, no man can stop. So I said, your baby will grow, you will deliver. She said, Pastor, are you sure? I said, I am not sure, but God has spoken. Son of man, can this bone live? Oh Lord, thou knowest. I said, I'm not sure, but God is sure, and I've spoken on his behalf. Guess what? She was taking communion every day. And I heard what I've never heard before. Baby grow, fibroid shrink. Baby grow, fibroid shrink. The baby was growing, fibroid was shrinking. I can't understand that mystery. Put your right hand on your head. If I'm truly sent to LFC Lafia for you, if truly I am sent to you, if truly I am your pastor, whatever has resisted your turnaround, by the liberation rod I came with, I break the barriers in the name of Jesus. Any power saying no to you and your family, I curse their roots in the name of Jesus. The strong man resisting your breakthrough, go down by fire. I pray for you. Whoever is sponsoring tears for you, for your family, I decree wailing in their cup. I command your tears to dry up now. In the name of Jesus. Whatever has made a mockery of you and your family, I speak forth. This week we are entering
Your turnaround has started. Your family turnaround has started. Whatever I was suspended spiritually in your life, I utter them spiritually in the name of Jesus. I command them to manifest physically in the name of Jesus. It is written, when the thief is caught, he shall be made to pay back 7 times. I pray for you. Whatever the enemy has collected from you, your wedding gown. Oh, there's someone that has snatched a wedding gown from her hand in the dream. I command that wedding gown restored. I command that wedding gown restored. I command that wedding gown restored. Whoever is monitoring your menstrual flow and is shooting arrow for you, God of Oyin go kill them. I command that evil hybrids to die. Whoever they have delegated to check whether you are pregnant to determine the next arrow for you, I decree vengeance of destruction. 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 I pray for you today. No more tears. No more tears. No more tears. No more tears. Every delay you have suffered, I revoke it right now. I revoke it right now. I revoke it right now. I command your destiny fast forwarded. I command your business fast forwarded. I push your family into breakthrough. Say amen like a believer. It is done. It is done. As we are casting our Thanksgiving offering now, we are going to be singing that song again. Everything is turning around. Are you ready? Oh yeah, be quick.
Hallelujah.
Lift up your offering right now, your Thanksgiving offering. As you drop this Thanksgiving offering, I am not a struggler. I didn't come to pastor struggling people. I came to bring you out to our ease of life. I pray for you. Everybody lift your hand up. The same impartation of blessing I've received from Bishop Oyedepo, Bishop Abiyoye, Paul Enenche, David Ibiomi, Johnson Suleiman, Bishop Aremu, Pastor Jeme, I duplicate the same favor upon you. I duplicate the same grace upon you. From today, you cease to struggle. I command helpers to locate you. Dream makers to locate you. It is done. In Jesus' name we pray. You are blessed.
I can see everything turning around, turning around for my God. Say I can see everything
turning around,
everything
turning around,
everything
turning around for my God.
Say I can see everything
turning around,
everything
turning around,
turning around. Say I can see everything, 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 turning around. So I can see everything, I can see it, I can see it. Oh, I can see success, I can see it. So I can see everything, everything, everything. So I can see everything. So I can see everything, everything, everything. So I can see everything, everything, everything. Say I can see everything, everything, everything. Say I can see everything, everything, everything. Turning around. Say I can see, I can see, I can see.